Radford County Redistricting Committee to order. If you will, please call the roll.
Craig Harris.
Here.
Jeff Phillips.
Present.
Wayne Blair. Joe Gurley.
Here.
John Marshall.
Here.
Ransom Jones.
Here.
Carolyn Cox.
Here.
Chairman Farley.
Here.
Mike Curtis.
Here.
And we have a quorum. Okay, now is the time we'll take a motion to approve the minutes from last week's meeting for September the 15th, 2021. Those were emailed out to everybody, had a chance to look over them. We have a motion on the minutes. We have a motion, do we have a second? We have a motion and a second. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Anyone oppose? Motion passes. Okay. All right. At our last meeting, or as of our last meeting, we've completed seven of the 21 districts. That's districts 4, 6, 15, 16, 17, 18, and 21. Last week, we kind of distributed a lot of population to various districts, but we only adopted District 16, and we did not take action on any of the others. And then we, you know, kind of took this week to kind of for everybody to look through the maps and kind of look through, see exactly thoughts were on that. So to start our meeting tonight, what I would like to do is the chair would like to offer some adjustments for consideration by the committee to bring many of these districts kind of that we left open from last week within the correct minimum and maximum deviations range.
Mr. Chairman, I would like to suggest that I don't know whether I need to make a motion to do this or just a suggestion that we do something similar to what we did last week. We make these adjustments, give us time to look at these things so that we can really think about them and scrutinize them carefully before we vote on them. So if we could just go through here and try to get things the best we can and not vote on these things, because as soon as we vote on one, we're gonna have to come back and possibly redo it and everything. So
that's right. Yeah, I mean, we'll go through because now we're kind of coming up on the end, and then I've kind of got a thought that I want to present to the committee after we finish tonight. So what we'll do is we're going to go through and just try to, you know, tweak here and there all the ones we did last week and try to get them based off of you know, the population shifts there. So we're not going to go and adapt or adopt one and then move to another, because what's going to end up happening is you're going to move from one, which is going to affect the other. So it's just going to all the pieces of the puzzle kind of coming together there at the end. So so what I want to do, Mike, if you would, let's just start District 1 and kind of go of all the districts we addressed last week. District 1, when we finished last week, was the deviation was right at a negative 1.59, and District 5 is over at is plus 14. So we need to get that, so we shift the population there. So what I wanted to do look at is on District 1, consider is the Fergus Road area right there, is to go ahead and let's look at that Fergus. It's in the southern part there off of 41, the Fisk Drive area. Let's move that to 12. Look at moving that to 12.
This area right in here?
Yes, yeah, so that would be from Fergus Road up to where it already connects to 12. So right there at Fergus Road, you're starting at 41 going up right past South Lake Court.
This area?
That there, yeah. Because that will, with it being 14 over, We've got a lot of population to move there. But one actually needs some population. And then, so looking at the, from Dick Buchanan Street, that'd be over to the left there. That there, over. Well, I tell you what, let's look at moving Dick Buchanan Street over all the way and see, moving that into one and see what that does.
This area in here?
Yes.
Okay.
I think that may be too much, but at least we can kind of figure out.
That's going to put one over by 2%.
Okay. You see the streets now.
What if you move a portion of the area you just moved into one, if you move a portion of that on into 12, because I think 12 still can take population?
Well, we're trying to take care of, we got to get one up. So one's, so I think 12 would be okay. One, so let's go right there where it says, all right, George Thomas down to Gene Mars over to Minerva, or.
Do you want to try to follow the creek here?
No, let's see if we can square it up if we can.
Okay.
So let's go down to George Thomas. That's that, not that section. Okay, let's go on the east, the west side of that.
Over here?
Yes.
And not this?
That there, yeah. All right, then that center, that the one little block there. And then let's follow Mercury and Dick Buchanan down to 41. Okay. So that puts. One at plus 2.1.
Yeah, right, here's your numbers right.
1.8. And so 5 is still over, correct?
Yes.
So that takes care of 1. So I'll tell you, if we go into that other part there, is it going to be a too large of a block?
In here?
Yeah.
If you go at that, you're right at the limit with 1.
But what we've done is we've actually just split right in half that residential.
Yeah, you have.
So let's keep that out then.
All right.
What if we move that portion there into 12? What will that make 12?
This area right here?
Yeah, that area.
Let me cancel this. That would put 12 at like 1.5% over.
How much?
1.5% over.
Oh, okay.
All right, so if we go ahead and go back to what we were talking about originally and lock that in, and then we'll need to go back, kind of widen the view and try to see if there's somewhere we can move the other part.
Did you want?
I tell you what, let's do. Hold on. All right. Let's go back. Let's go over to far west side of 5.
The west side of 5. You mean here on 24?
Yeah. Okay. What we let's go ahead and we put all this, that one section was in District 12 originally, and so we went ahead and put it in 5.
Yeah, this
but
area.
10's gonna have 10's gonna have to grow some more, so let's go ahead. It's start at that section right above Team Boulevard in the corner.
In here?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you've got the Laverne city limits here and Smyrna city.
Okay,
limits.
Let's Let's go in that and see what we got there.
You want me to put this into 10?
Yes, sir. Is most of that commercial?
Some of it is. Some of it's residential. That takes 5 down to minus 4.21 and takes 10 up to almost 17.
Okay. Let's go ahead and lock that in. And then let's go back over here to 11.
Where in 11 do you want to go?
Where we actually, east of Rocky Fork, where we actually moved part of 11 into 10.
Talking about over in here.
Right there. All right. You know, that's the blue section that's east of Rocky Fork. We need
all
to move,
this?
Listen, we need to move that back to 11.
Okay.
Because what we end up doing is we've got 5 we've got to take care of, but we need to try to keep that section and try to keep it as in contingent with Laverne as much as possible.
Want all of this in 11. That's going to bring 10 down to minus 4.44.
Okay. Yeah, so what we're doing, this, we're going to be doing some redistributing, so some are going to go high or low, so just be patient with me here for just a second.
All right.
Okay, go ahead and lock that back in 11. Okay, so let's go back up to 5. Okay, if we go ahead and...
Oh, wait a minute. Somehow I got this in 10. Hold on just a second. That's going to make our numbers off.
Yeah, that's
going to... I don't know how that happened. Hold on just a second.
That would go to 1.
Yep. That's why I look at these numbers all the time. Stuff like this happens.
What I want to do now is try to get the most western part, 1 in 5, set... And that way, we'll move everything in kind of in the middle, in between.
That's going to put 10 at minus 7.21.
Okay, but 1 is what?
1 is 1.22 over.
Okay, so one is set. One is good. Okay. All right. Then 5 is at
minus 4.21. It is also good as it currently stands.
Okay. So let's go and pull. Let's add some more into 10. No, 10's over, right?
10 is under currently.
Okay. So let's go up that section we were working on.
In here?
There, right there. Let's go ahead and let's add some more. Just to...
You want to follow up Cheney and Old National Highway?
No,
or do you want to go over here?
No, I think we need to use Old Nashville Highway as our definite boundary there. But what about it? We've got some odd shape census blocks there. So
yes.
Where can we do this to kind of make this a little more compact?
You go down Mason Road to Sanders to Cheney, like that. I don't know what to do.
All right, so that area right there that your cursor's on right there, all right, what is our smallest census block we can get to right there with that population and that subdivision without taking in that whole mass?
Here's your population numbers. You got 801 in this block here, which is, I'll just show you what it looks like. Looks like that.
Okay, then let's go get that 160, 85, 72, and 74 and see what we've got there. Which our census folks will learn how to draw a straight line, though.
That would put 5 at minus 4.21. Oh, excuse me, no, excuse me. That would put 5 at minus 12.
Okay, so that's too much.
Yeah, that's too much.
Okay. Let's take that section except for that large 801 section.
It's going to look really weird. And there's nothing contiguous to 10.
All right, so if we take Cheney Road up to where it connects there, what, how's
in
that?
In here?
Yeah.
That puts one at, why did it go with one? Hold on just a second, I'm sorry. I was trying to put it in one instead of 10. All right, 5 to 10. I'm going to put 5 at minus 7.51 and 10 at minus 3.92.
That's going to be over for 5. All right, what about if we, instead of going all the way to that point on Old Nashville Highway, what if we cut that in half?
That's, that 463 is that weird block there. It's going to be kind of hard to do that.
Oh.
The only thing down here is the other side of the Laverne High School, and that's 0.
Okay, so but 5, so 5 is okay, though.
5 as it stands currently is okay.
Okay, so that means we've got 1 and 5 that are within the margins. Okay.
All yes, right. Sir.
Then we've got 10 needs to actually
add some.
Needs to grow.
I can't hear you, Commissioner.
Can you get the stats for 5 and 10 back up on the screen? What are they?
5 is minus 4.21, 10 is minus 7.21.
And let's go to the northern part
okay.
of 9. To where 9 meets, okay. Let's go to that Montgomery off of Rock Springs, that Montgomery Road down to Lee Road.
Okay.
Over
to Rocky Fork. All right, so we're going to go from 9 to 10. Is that what you're looking at?
Yes. Where does that put 10?
That puts 10 over at 7.83 and 9 at minus 1.32.
Okay,
what if you split that in the middle? Just follow Montgomery Way and put everything north of Montgomery Way in the.
This is Montgomery Way right here.
But there's another one. There's another road.
There's
in
a
there.
Montgomery Road that comes down
yeah.
through here. But if you look at it, that's all one big block right there.
So
that's what I'm saying. Put that big block into 10 and leave and see what happens.
That is, yeah, the inner block there instead of all the way down to Lee.
So what you're saying is this?
Yes, and then to the right there. Part of 9 that's actually right there adjacent to 24.
Yeah, there's a blank area right there.
Right here?
Yes.
Right there.
That's all part of that.
Oh, okay.
That's all one block, and it's only 12 people.
Even with that, though, it's still 2% over deviation, right?
Yes, almost 3% over.
What can we do to reduce from that, what you have coded now?
With these two large blocks here in space, one being almost 2,000 people and one only being 12, there's not much you can do with it.
How about going back out to the west, go back to the county line, out Rock Springs, scroll back over, and start putting stuff in, because you've got some blocks out there that don't have too many people, but as you move in from that area right there, it may be easier to do.
It's going to, okay, so what you're saying is...
From the county line back, make Lee Road the south boundary, but start working from the county line back, do away with that.
He's saying go from Montgomery Way...
This way.
West.
West, instead of the...
As it runs along Rock Springs, so really, you're going, we're going, yeah.
That makes Tenet minus 11 point, or no, excuse me, Tenet minus 0.07 and 9 at 6.57.
Okay. All right. For sake of discussion, let's lock that in. Okay, so right now, 1, 5, and 10 are within the margins, correct?
That's where Smyrna annexed.
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right, so then let's go to, so now let's look at 9. So now 9 needs to lose some. So let's go down to south part of 9.
Can you put part of... How is 8 right now?
Well, right now what we're doing, we're just trying to shift to trying to, I mean, this is the slow, mundane part of this whole process.
Right.
As we're trying to get that balance. So, let's go ahead and look at 9. Take 9 all the way down to Franklin Road 96.
You want to add more to 9?
Yes.
From 8. That puts 8 at negative 7.
Okay. All right. So let's go back up north of 9 and look at balance between 9 and 10.
All right. So you want me to commit this then?
Yes.
All right.
This is kind of, this part of the process here is kind of like with your wife or your spouse, okay, moving furniture around in a room, trying to figure out which way you want the living room to look. Okay, so now with 10, we are, so 10 can gain or it could actually lose. So 9 needs to lose some more population. So is there a way to come in, and this really boils down to where the census blocks lie, but what can we do to go into that point up there at 24, where 9 and 10 there, how far can we come down? It's not going to look all that great, but we have that one big section there, though, that's causing us the issue, isn't it?
Yes. If we go from 9 to 10, that's just one block right there.
You've got one little section up there that is a separate block, if you put that over into there. And then you've got some separate blocks down here.
Yes, sir, I'm aware of that. I'm just fixing to pick them up and just make it as a total package here.
No, I was talking about putting those individually over into 10.
Well, you can't because we're not contiguous to 10. That one big block is what's causing us the problem.
Yeah, I realize that.
That puts 10 at 15%.
Yeah, that's going to be way too much. What if you put this block back here north of Rocky Fork into 10? You do away with what you've got there now.
In here?
No, back over to the west once again.
Rocky Fork is all the way down here.
Yeah.
And then up here.
Yeah.
Are you talking about in here?
Yeah, I'm talking about in there.
Well, if we, Mike, let's look at this. All right, so now we've got a loose population. So if we move, if we, that one block, that 1,841 people is what's causing us. Because our boundaries are tight everywhere else except for trying to figure out how we can maneuver this one section here. We're locked in to the east. We're locked into the north. Well, I tell you what, let's go back up to 5. Can we pick up that section where it says Wolverine Trail? Good. Let's look at this, Mike. Let's just go ahead and just take that section that we just did there. Sam Ridley, let's take that out. And then let's go back to the original way it was, Cheney Road to that point, and just look at the way it was designed back when it was in 12.
All right, so you're wanting all of this to go back into 5?
Yes, sir. Put all that back into 5. And then we'll take Cheney Road up north to Old Nashville Highway down the triangle there.
And then you want this triangle?
Yeah, that triangle there, move it to 10.
All right.
It's odd shaped, but it may be that's the only way we've got to make this work. That'd be the reason why it was designed that way, shaped that way in the beginning.
That's going to put 5 at 1.9. And 10 at minus 3.8.
Now we need to find a small section to add back to 5, right?
5 is good. It's 10 that you've got to add some to, just a small bit.
Okay, it's 10, I'm sorry.
Yes, sir.
What is the deviation of 10 right now?
It's 0.538, so if it picks up 40 people, it's going to get it within the 5.
Down in the Laverne area, right off of I-24.
And
won't that be in 10? I mean, that's 700-800.
That's at Blair and Walden.
Unfortunately, you have to consider what the 2020 numbers are.
I know, but it would be okay if it were under, because growth is going to happen in that area.
Yes, sir.
We're going to have so much growth, it ain't going to matter.
Right, I mean, it's going to end up being, we have to base it off 2020 numbers, so even though we...
I understand, but what I'm saying is that we know because of Laverne passing that huge, it's what is it, 600-700 houses?
Mm-hmm.
Something like that. That's going to go in 10, right?
Right.
So if 10... were under, in my mind, it should be okay because it's really going to grow.
Well, I mean, I think the biggest thing is that even though we know there's going to be growth, based off our boundaries, I'm more concerned about getting our districts more compact and contiguous and to where it's the defined boundaries. So if we end up being over, you know, say we're 3% over, we're within the range. But it takes it out of the defined boundaries. That's my, and I know what you're saying is you're kind of painting for the representation of having a commissioner having to represent, you know, within a 4-year term. That's what makes it kind of hard. We know what the future lies, but we're having to deal with the numbers in the past. Mm-hmm. Right, exactly. Exactly. Yeah, yes, absolutely. I agree. I tell you what, Mike, let's go over to where 10 and 11 Because we can't, right there with nine, we can't go get a sliver because that one big, huge block.
Well, what if we, if you don't mind me interjecting, sir, what if we put all this back in nine and put this in 10?
That, they wouldn't.
But that was with all of this up here.
Okay, well, let's look at that then, okay.
That puts nine and 10 well within the limits.
Perfect. Okay, so we got one, five, and 10. The most western, northwestern part lot, so those are good, okay. So then nine is good, right?
Currently, yes.
Okay, and so, and now is that, that's with adding that out of eight too, correct? We've already?
Yes, sir.
Okay, all right. So.
Actually, no, that, yeah, that takes nine all the way down to 96, yeah.
Now, let's go down to, so eight is got to gain some, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, if I tell, let's do this. Go down to seven and eight to where, that section there at St. Andrews, right there, yeah. Let's move that back to eight. From St. Andrews to 99. Yes, that block, that section right there.
Okay.
That was originally in eight, St. Andrews is the boundary there, so.
That's going to put eight at .49 under and seven at 6.55 under.
Okay, so, all right, so we're good there. All right, let's lock that in. Okay, now if we go back over on the east side of seven, because what we did, and what I noticed there, part of up north there on the river, yeah, that part there, we actually split this boundary. We've got a natural boundary with Stones River that runs from 99. Then we moved off of it and then moved on to Indian Park. Let's move that section of Indian Park boundary back to the river. So that section there will go into seven. Yes, but we saw an error somehow that was made when Mike and I were looking over this. We took two census blocks, it was an 18, somehow it got clicked into 21, but that'll remedy that. I think it was one of those that just, it got clicked and then we forgot about it. Okay, so seven puts that at 3.2 over, so that's in range, okay. Now, let's go back to that Baird and Main Street right there at 18 and 21, because I think that move there makes 18 way under. So that section of Baird, that right in there, that needs to go back into 18.
Let's put both of them within parameters.
Okay, so that shift kind of lines everything back up and back to their more defined natural boundaries there. Okay.
I've got an unassigned or a non-contiguous block here that I'm just going to put 19. Give me just a second, please.
Okay.
I saw that during the week, and I just hadn't changed it. Just clean up. Thank you for indulging me.
Okay, and then also 20, 19 is one we'll have to work about. 20 is one that we, oh, another one right here too. Go to 13 there at 99, since we're in that, was in that area. There's a, right there, yeah. There is a block there, or that 15 people there, part, I think that needs to go into 16. Because it makes River Rock the boundary, then you get that little section there, it jumps over. So, that cleans that up there, so it. And then 13, we moved in the 96 area. 20 has to lose a,
actually, 19
has to net gain, but.
Yeah, 19 needs to lose a bunch, and so 20 can move into 19 some.
Okay, so let's take this section in 13 that was, we ended up moving at 19, but it's that Pascal Drive area.
This area right here.
Yeah, let's move that back to 13. That's in 13 currently, but we. Okay. So 13's.
13 is good, good as it stands.
Okay. So now we've got 20 needs to grow. All right. So let's look at that part in the northern, well, not northern, the south west corner of
over
96
here.
And Veterans right there. That's a Kroger, I think, right there on that corner,
yeah.
Isn't it? So let's go from Puckett Creek over to Veterans and then go up to that subdivision up there.
Here?
Well, is that a municipal boundary that's?
It, some of these are.
That's zero is Middle Tennessee Electric, that property that they own.
Right here.
South of there is the Cloister.
Okay, if we let's go, if we go all the way up there, we're going to get in a lot of trouble. So let's go with a lot of population. Let's go to that part right there. Was it Lure Court?
Yeah, I'd like to point out something that this block right here is.
Yeah, we're going to have to end up taking that too.
Yeah, you're going to have to come all the way up into here plus all these.
I think the population number wise, we're going to have that. Well, that's good. All right. What does that put 20?
It puts 20 at 4.88 over.
There's no way to really reduce that number because there's those odd shaped blocks.
Yeah. Well, you can take 18 out here, but that's about it.
That's not going to help much. Okay. All right. Lock that in for 20. All right. So that helps. 19's got a. Lose 20, so that locks 20 in. Okay, so what we had worked on last week, so now we have to, what we really have now is to try to address the District 19, and that currently is 16% over.
You've got 3, 11, 14, and 19 that are all out of whack.
But the 3 is the one
and
we
two.
Had. We had 3 and 2. We hadn't gotten to those two as of yet. So that's yeah. All right, let's go to 11. I forgot about 11. I'm sorry. That part that we added, that's east of Lee Victory Parkway, that was in 19. We moved
and
it over
here?
When we took that section. So since we moved that back, that section out of 10 back to 11, let's move that 11 back to 19.
Okay. You want to, like, go down to Stewart's Creek?
Just follow it down to the creek there.
Okay.
I think, was that Stewart's Creek?
It is.
Stewart's Creek High School's always, oh, does that creek go all the way down to south of there?
It covers a large portion of the county.
And use your boundary there, it's at, all right, so that.
That brings 11 closer, but it's not quite there yet.
All right, we've still got to take that part up there, all right, but let's block that into 19.
All right.
Because 3 is over the old Nashville Highway boundary, right?
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's put that section.
This right here?
Moved into 11, move it to 3.
Okay.
Because old Nashville Highway is the. Boundary there between.
Still puts 11 over by a quarter percent.
11 is still over?
There's 490 people here on the south side that if you just made Lee Victory.
Okay, take it to 19.
Yeah. Here. That's going to put 11 at 2.24 over, which would be good.
Okay, so that locks 11 in. All right, and 12 is.
12 is
good. Okay.
Good.
All right, so right now, with the shifts that we've made, we still have 19 to address. We have 19, 14, and 3 and 2, which we haven't even gotten to those two yet. Correct?
Yeah, that looks like the, and yeah, 3, 2, 14, and 19, yes.
Okay, so let's go ahead, let's go ahead and work on 19 and make the changes we need to make there. So right now, 19 is 35% over, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, all right, so let's go down to. All right, so 14's got to grow 26. So really the epicenter here now is 14 and 19.
Yes, sir.
Okay, well, if we take in, all right, so if we end up moving 14 into 19, then what that's going to end up doing is end up taking the big chunk, which were over 19, and so that should balance those two. But the repercussions of that is it's going to put Commission District or Commissioner 19 into 14. 14 is a district that does not have a, or will not have an incumbent commissioner. I'm searching for direction from our commissioners in the room now.
Let's do it and see where we stand. I think we're going to have to do some more changes, so I think we're going to have to play with it and just see where we go.
All right, go ahead and make that. Marshall, he was going to say something. Okay.
Chairman, so we're saying that number 9, our 19th county commissioner, we're looking at him now being running for District 14.
Correct. Which is not the first time that's ever happened. There's been times, especially when you get into legislative seats, where you have basically, you'll have, the numbers will change. And that's basically what's happened is that number, the district number has changed.
So can you show us where he lives?
He lives right there.
So it may end up being that the bulk of his previous district's population may end up being moving with him into 14.
Yeah. Because he's in the center of that quadrant right there. And the unique thing about that is it's, and I know this because when we did the vote centers, New Vision Church and Stewartsboro Elementary, the road there, 840, it's almost right at the very center point. So really what you're doing is that part of his district that's in his area is, yeah, it is moving. I didn't think about it, but it is moving following that area there too. Please use your mic, Ms. Cox.
Thank you. Are we attempting to find balance and get to the deviation, or are we more concerned about where commissioners live and making sure that they stay within their boundaries? I mean, I know and I understand that that would be a desire, but we've got too much growth and too much shifting to be sitting here debating where someone lives and what commission they're, where they need to run for office later. I think the bigger concern should be making sure that we've got the blocks appropriately done so that we can get the deviations within range.
I agree with you 100%, but we're recommending this to a body that has final approval that, you know, so it's one of those things of, you know, that this would be a dramatic change. So I'm 100% with you. That's what works. That's what gets your populations shifted. And, you know, sometimes it can be even worse. Well, but this is.
I think, you know, I think it's desirable not to pit two incumbent commissioners against each other that already have a political foothold and founding. But just to change the district number, I don't personally see a big deal about it. You're still, and this is a majority of the population that Commissioner Key has cultivated, and he's actually going to be in his district if we move it to 14. And so I think we need to go forward with this, and as was stated, that get these numbers right, then we'll come up worry about any fine things.
That's fine with me. Let's go ahead and move back that quadrant there, Mike, you've already got that.
I've already done that.
Gotcha. Okay.
The other thing I'd like to point out is that we're still got to move some more, though, from 19 to 14.
Right. But I'm just, that was the biggest bulk there, so I wanted to.
What if we go 14 to Florence?
All the way up to Florence. That's a good chunk of people. We can try it. That puts both of them within target.
Okay. All right. So go ahead and lock that in. Now the part it's 840 Northwest Broad Street corridor. There is that's an unpopulated area. There would let's go ahead and move that into 14 as well.
That you want to go down to Overall Creek and the river?
Yeah. We're talking about 12 people, but it does it
yeah,
gives it,
basically
it gives it
12 people.
It gives it better shape.
Yeah, it makes it a better defensible boundary. Like that?
Yes. Okay. All right, so by going all the way to Florence, so that would take in Florence Road east to Wilkerson Pike, and then north back up to, or north east back up toward Memorial. Okay, all right, so where does that put 19? 19 is at 4.94, so it's within the range.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Is there any, so three is where? So it's got a, three's got a gain.
Three still has to gain some.
Okay. So let's look at a 14 is in good shape. Okay. So let's go over to the old Nashville Highway. So three and 19. So 19 can actually has more to give. Three needs more to. All right. What about this Burleson Lane area?
This area right here has been traditionally a boundary before, yes. You want to move that from 19 to 3?
What's that give us?
It brings 3 within parameters. 19 is still over by a little, but not nearly as much.
How much is 19 over? It's
2.12 over now.
But it's within the range?
Yes, sir.
All right, so 19 is in range, 3 is in range.
2 currently is the only thing that is out of range.
Okay, all right. It's 2/10 or 2%. All right, so let's go up and we're 2 and 3. Go down to down front of the VA on 231. That little sliver there across, let's put that into 14.
This here?
Yes. 14 can take, well, that's only just 85 people there. But that way, that gives that defined boundary there of 231.
And close to that, because I know there's some small slivers in here. Got them.
Okay, because there's, well, that's 118 or so.
If you don't mind, let me move these zeros that are on the other side of 231 over here into 2.
Okay.
Please. Makes that a nice clean boundary. Yeah.
Okay, so we're 2 and 3, or 2 already comes over and overlaps up in the northern part there. What's that section right here? It's got the in between the 266 and Kendrick Cove. That was got 29. That may be an odd shape, right down below there.
This right here?
No, right. Then the green spot there. I guess that's in 14.
Oh, this?
Yeah.
Yeah, this is all in 14 currently. This is the river. This is the East Fork of the Stones River right here. If anything, this probably needs to be in 3.
Okay, all right, we'll move back to 3. To keep everything on that side of these fork. Okay, all right. If we go into that section, go further north, because there, that area up in there, is there a way to take in that part up, or is that too much population up north there to kind of block that section off there?
The nice thing with Fall Creek here is you've got a nice boundary here that you could take little chunks and see what it does. So if you moved like this from 3 to 2.
Okay.
That puts two within boundaries, but three still need some. And I would like to point out this area right here, this is all part of this one huge block here. So this is a creek, even though it's going to look odd, it is how the census geography is drawn.
So if we go into, how far up the Powell's Chapel did we go?
Powell's Chapel is here. Runs up through here. You know, you do have some population in 14 that you can give to 3 to balance it out.
What if you move those little odd areas? Is that one census tract, or is that some pockets up here, just where you have the indentation of 14 into 2, right in there?
This area here?
Yeah, what do the census tracts look like there? Those are all 0 census tracts.
Yeah. You don't start getting into this population until you get in this subdivision
here.
Yeah,
because they're right along the river, yeah. Okay. Yeah.
There's a creek running here. This is city limits line here. You got a city limits line here. You do have an area through here that you could very well put from 14 into 3. If you so chose. Is that what you want to see?
Yeah, let's do that. That's the back part of Cherry Lane Acres, and then it's the one off of Central Valley, right?
That wouldn't look good. Again, this is one of those census geography things. But that's going to put 14 too low.
Well, all right, let me ask you this. And this is, okay, all right, this part over here, Allen Road area, and this is one thing as far as trying to look at 3, this is what makes 3 difficult. And this is what I was talking about when he had the northern part of Laverne, that point basically goes all the way from there, all the way to Memorial. If we take that there from, give that to 3.
This area here?
No.
No.
What do you have now? Let's lock that into 3.
All right.
All right. But then take this section. Go ahead and do a wide view of 3, because here I want you to kind of look at 3. 3, you've got population in the southern part of that district and in the northern part of that. I mean, so there's you've got a lot of land mass there that's just not much population. But that area's got to go somewhere. 3 lost the Smyrna portion of right there behind Nissan and area, so that helped out quite a bit. Then also that northern part. Three is over at 4.8. 12 is under at 3.2, but then what you're getting into, you're getting into land mass with no population because you're up on the other side of the river or the lake. I think the balance, we got to find the balance between 2, 3, and 14. So 14 right now is 2% under. 3 is 4% over, and 2 is, all right, I'll tell you what, let's look up at that northern part there that we were at earlier, the Powell's right there.
Here.
Can we pull, okay, oh, let's go a little bit outside of that, right there in three. Can we shift some of that back, move that into two?
Not easily. We could hit 100 right here, following the creek down to Powell's Chapel Road, and then Powell's Chapel Road down this way. There's 100 people there. But if you get into here, you get those weird block shapes because of the way the subdivisions are developed.
What if you just stay east of Powell's Chapel all the way up?
You saying right here?
You probably pull back two to just have, keep two on the east side of Powell's Chapel.
Oh, you're talking about over here. No, it's west. Sorry, this is east.
No, yeah. That, go back up because, you know, Powell's Chapel runs right across Bill France Boulevard. Is that right?
Bill France, yeah.
Yeah, they come down that way. Follow Powell's Chapel down to right there.
That's a and, creek.
Okay, okay. Follow that down then that way.
Like this?
Yes.
That's what I was talking about. You got okay. 100 people right there.
I'm talking about on the right side of that line.
Oh, over here?
Yes.
You've got probably 1,500 people over here. There's at least 1,000 right there, and there's another 200 there, and then there's at least another 300
over here. All right, I'll tell you what let's do. Let's look at this. Go ahead and do that. All right, go ahead and do that.
All right.
It's something, I'm looking at something here.
That's fine.
Entertain me, please. All right, then go to that 100 there you were talking about.
Hit that 100, okay.
Okay. All right, so you see the boundary, it falls down, it falls to Powell's Chapel?
Mm-hmm.
Now, that puts two at what?
5.19.
All right, now, let's look at the left side of Powell's Chapel, west to Mona Road.
You were still wanting to add to two?
No, what I'm saying is now, what we've done is we've made Powell's Chapel from the northernmost part all the way down to Jefferson Pike, everything east in District 2, everything west would be in 3. So now we would lock that in.
You want to put all this into 3 is what
three,
you're saying?
Yeah.
Okay.
So what we're doing is we're swamping, but we're taking Powell's Chapel and creating that as our boundary because it's...
I see what you're doing.
Go from, and it may not work population-wise, but I mean, just.
Yeah. Actually, that did really well. I put both of them just right at 1%, either plus or minus. And it's Powell's Chapel Road the whole way.
So now 14 is the only one left that we've got to get within the margin, right? Okay, so 14, so what bounding 14? Possibility.
16 has 3.75, yeah.
That Mitchell Nelson area there.
What over about, here?
Yeah, that, I'm just looking at options now. So we have, mm-hmm. have that three. Well, it's
come all the way down to Peachtree.
Where's Clark? Clark is.
Northfield is here, so Clark is right here. This is Clark.
Let's go down to Clark. That may be too much, but let's.
All right. A little too far.
Seven one-hundredths of a point.
What if you take down to whatever that drive is? There's a drive, something drive that goes all the way across east to west right there. Right there, yeah.
This is Peachtree Street.
Yeah, if you take everything north of there and put it into...
Oops, I didn't mean to commit that.
What you're doing, though, you're splitting up that, community you're splitting right in half. I mean, if you go there, you're still only seven-tenths or seven-one-hundredths over, off your margin. So it's tweaking somewhere here or there. Truly, legally, we're okay, even though we're seven-one-hundredths, because your total deviation is within 10%.
Yeah, we're at 9.95%.
And you can't get much closer than that.
Legally, this is good.
I mean, I'd like to get it. I say Clark Boulevard is really that defining area between that, because, you know, Jones Boulevard, Hamilton, and Battleground, that whole section there probably should try to stay together if we can, if at all possible. All right, so with that there, okay, all right. As it stands now, do you see anything that you want to recommend? I mean, any changes, any objections to where we are at this point?
Ones that we've adjusted, can we run through those real quick to see the over and unders and where we are with those?
Okay, I tell you what, Mike, let's just go through all 21. Because here's what I'd like to do is, Mr. Gurley mentioned, we're not going to vote on each individual district tonight. What I want to do is, after we get through tonight, we're going to send everybody a copy of the map tomorrow, like what we did this past week. You look over it, scan through it. If you see tweaks here or there, any recommendations, we'll come back to the next meeting. And then we can make, and there may be some, there may be five, there may be none. I mean, or maybe 100. But what we'll do, we'll look at those. And at that point in time, if everything falls in right, then we may adopt this. I mean, we could be done. But I don't want to just say, okay, we've got it, boom, adopt it, let's go. I want to go back, take it, walk away from it, come back to it, then kind of look at it objectively again, and kind of study it before we make the final recommendation. Is that good with everybody? What'd you say, Mr. Gurley? Oh, okay. All right. So, Mike, let's go ahead and go through the deviations for all 21 districts.
Okay. District 1 in the Laverne area is plus 1.22. It's this area here. District 2, which is the Walter Hill, Las Casas, Milton area, is minus 1.06. District 3, which is the other half of Walter Hill and the Leanna and part of the Florence area, is plus 1.19. District 4, which is the Kittrell area and part of West or East Murfreesboro, is minus 1.19. District 5, which is part of Laverne, is 1.09. District 6, which is the Midland, Christiana, Fosterville, Buchanan area, is minus 1.65. District 7, which is the Southwest Murfreesboro area, Salem, that type of area, is plus 3.20. District 8, which is Rockvale, Eagleville, is minus 0.49. District 9, which is the Ammaville, Stewart's Creek area, West Smyrna is plus 3.82. District 10, which is also West Smyrna and Southern Laverne, is plus 2.52. District 11, which is Central Smyrna, 2.24. District 12, which is Eastern Smyrna and the airport area, is minus 3.2. District 13, which is West Murfreesboro, minus 4.32. District 14, which is part of the Florence area, part of East Murfreesboro, part of North Murfreesboro, is plus 1.44. District 15, which is North Central Murfreesboro, is plus 0.92. District 16, which is essentially Central Murfreesboro, is currently at minus 5.07. District 17, which is the MTSU area, is minus 2.50. District 18, which is Central to South Central Murfreesboro, is minus 3.54. District 19 is part of Florence and the rest of West Murfreesboro and some of Salem, is 2.12. District 20, which is West Central Murfreesboro, is 4.88 over. And District 21, which is Southeast Murfreesboro, is minus 1.63.
Okay, so all of them fall within the range. 16 is actually 7/100ths of a percent over, but it's within the total deviation of all 21, so it's we're legal there. So as far as the min and max, we have met that requirement at this point. What I would like to do now is, unless somebody's got any other suggestions or recommendations, any tweaks, we can go ahead and adjust and make those. Or we could go ahead and we have finished our work for tonight, but then, like I said, tomorrow, well, we'll get maps prepared, the electronic format, send them out to you, and then that way you kind of look through. Because here's what I'd like for you to look at. Is looking at, definitive boundaries, rivers, railroad tracks, major highways, where at all possible. I think we have met that part. I think that every guideline that we have set forth in the beginning, we have met that. But just I want to kind of look at that, and if you see. And it may just come down to what we got into a while ago with 9 and 10. It's just that those blocks, the way they're designed, the census blocks are determined by the Census Bureau, it makes it almost impossible to make those tweaks. But then at that point, come back, and then our next meeting, make whatever changes or look at whatever adjustments at that point, and then whatever the wishes and will of the committee is at that point going forward. What's the committee's thoughts on that? I don't want to, okay, we're done. Okay, now let's go ahead and adopt it and be over with it. My office has to live with this for 10 years. So what I want to do is I want to make sure it's done right. It's done, and not rushed. But also, too, I want it to be legal. I want it to be, meet all the requirements and guidelines that we set forth with at the beginning of this process. So I'll entertain a motion for what we just discussed.
One comment before we make a motion. I think the citizens have to live with this for 10 years. So, we need to go back and you know, it's one thing to do it here. Like I said earlier, it's another thing to sit down at your home computer on a screen where you can scroll, zoom, and look and say, get down to this and say, okay, this just don't make sense. But maybe it does because the census block won't let you do anything else. And so I think it's really good that we've done well. We've got the time. I'd like to present this to the October commission, and I think we can. But yeah, I'll go ahead now and make a motion that we adjourn for the night, have this sent to us, and let us scrutinize this and follow up on it and come back to look at it and tweak it and make a final vote next week if we come to that point.
Yeah, well, I don't want to adjourn just yet, but just far as moving forward, that's our step for the next
right,
meeting.
Let's okay. move okay. forward and get these maps, look at them, come back next week.
Yeah. All right. We have a motion. Do we have a second? Motion and a second. All in favor of the motion, say aye.
Aye.
Anyone opposed? Motion passes. Okay. So one last thing I do want to do is looking at as far as the school and road board zones, going through making sure that we do have those. They are contiguous. We do have zone one, which is districts 5, 11, and 12. 5, 11, and 12 are contiguous. We have zone 2, which is districts 1, 2, and 3. So those are contiguous. We have zone 3, which is 4, 6, and 7. So 4, 6, and 7 is tied in the 6 there. Okay, zone 4 is districts 8, 9, and 10. 8, 9, and 10 there. And then zone 5 is districts 17, 18, and 21. And that's contiguous there. Zone 6 is districts 13, 15, and 16. So 13 joins 16, 16 joins 15. So we have that. And then zone 7 is districts 14, 19, and 20. 14, 19, and 20 there, okay? And then as far as any elected official that was we have pinpointed and part of our guidelines are set of being drawn outside of their zone, I don't see any school or road board member that was taken out of their zone. They may have been moved into another district, but it's within their zone, so we met that requirement as well. So, okay. All right. Any other business to come before the committee for this evening? Okay. Path forward is what we'll do is tomorrow we'll come in and Mike will get a map and everything prepared, kind of like what we did last week, to go ahead and then we'll get that email to you. Then that way, so when you get it over the weekend, first part of next week, you can go through and just kind of look at each district and take a look at the north, south, east, west, all the various boundaries of each district. See, is there anything that any tweaks or anything that you think that may be advantageous for the map, any changes that you might want to recommend. So once that's done, then our next meeting will come back. We'll go through each district and clearly define, make sure that our boundaries are what we intended them to be. We don't have any unintended consequences. We don't have any census blocks that have not been allocated. And I think that
I've already checked that.
Okay, so we're good there because we don't want to have something unassigned that's not tied in contiguous to that district. So all that, and then once we're set at that point, if we make one change, if we make 60 changes or we make zero changes, at the next meeting, we'll be prepared to adopt the full map. And then at that point, the committee's work is done, and we have fulfilled the requirements set forth by statute. We've set forth the requirements set forth by what the steering committee and the county commission had given us. And then it's in their hands for them to determine what they want to do. And then at that point, once it's presented at the October County Commission meeting, if it's adopted, our work is done. If they want to amend it, or if they want to reject it, they can send it back to us for us to take another stab at it. Or if they could actually amend it on the floor of the county commission, and they could get into a knockdown, drag out, or however y'all want to do, fighting over certain territory. I mean, that's up for 21 commissioners to decide. We want to recommend it with these changes and send it back to us, and we make the changes. But at that point, it's up to the county commission's direction at that point. Next Wednesday. We'll meet next Wednesday.
Okay. A comment. Going into this thing, I was really concerned about the way the population, I don't mean to say shift, but has grown in certain areas has outgrown other areas. And it's a really difficult process. I'm not one to say that we ought to be protecting turf or those kinds of things, but we were able to accomplish that. This committee was able to accomplish that and still make the map look, in my mind, a lot better than it was, our old map. So all of these things, to me, look a lot better than it did before. And even number 14 and number 19, the ones that got a little bit confusing, where that commissioner lives, he'll still have a lot of his, what would have been his voting block in the new 14th district. Me, I'm surprised that we've got to where we got to as quickly as we got to, and it's just my hat's off to all of this committee, but Mike and Alan, just what you guys have done has just been absolutely amazing. Being on the Planning Commission, I'm seeing how we're continuing to grow, and that's a real scary thing, simply because the complaints that we're getting right now is that we don't have safety issues with roads and those kinds of things, but I shudder to think what the next committee will be going through 10 years from now. Population is 5% more than it is today, and where that growth is going to go. It's a scary thing. I don't know what you thought about that, but I know that there are some areas that haven't experienced growth that's as much growth that's going to start experiencing. Complaints that I think we'll be hearing will be where that growth goes, and that'll be out of our hands and in the Planning Commission's hands. My hat's off to you guys. Thank you, Mike. Thank you, Alan.
Well, thank you, Jeff. I mean, and one thing to look at, if you'll look back, and one thing, there's always going to be a dramatic shift because with as much growth as we've had. But if you'll look back from 1990, the 2000, 2010, and now, most 90% of your districts are the same. I mean, it's the same area because it's just whether has it shrunk, has it expanded. But because you look back with a couple exceptions, District 1 has always been kind of, or 3 has been different because of the shape of that northern part. But what you're doing is you're looking at the districts from 1990, District 8's not that much change. District 6 is not that much change. District 4, District 2. And even, you know, but in 10 years ago, there was a district that shifted, and that was 19. And then this, because it's right there in the, in kind of where the middle of all that growth is, and it's the gateway between the western part and then the central part of the county. So, but for us to walk away with a map that's somewhat reflective of what the map has been for the last 30 years, I think that says a lot in itself, because in dealing with the voters, we want to make the least amount of change and impact on the voters, which is a little different for us now because the vote centers, they're not assigned to a certain location, because people get very defensive or get very mad when you take them away from their normal assigned voting place that they've been for a multiple of years. But since we don't have that anymore with vote centers, but so I commend the committee for working and having the foresight to trying to keep the communities together, and also making sure that we don't really stray away from dramatic change in those counties, because the voters then will be confused, and I don't want to do anything that would deter voter turnout. So, but anybody else have any comments or any suggestions? All right. That being said, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.